Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's look at a simple way to create flashcards on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, while there are apps you can download and websites that you can subscribe to that allow you to create flashcards, you could do so on your Mac simply using Keynote. You usually use Keynote for presentations, but you can make each slide a flashcard. So let's start with a theme here. Now you can choose just about any theme you want. Basic white and basic black will work. I'm going to choose something a little more fun here. I'm going to choose the graph paper theme under Portfolio. And then once I'm in here, I can take a look at the different slides by clicking Add Slide. Now we want a slide that's going to work well as a flashcard. Something that has two parts to it, the question and answer. Now the title and subtitle slide here work really well, and they will in most themes. But there are other options as well. For instance, the quote one might work too. But we'll stick with title and subtitle. And since that's the first template slide here, it's the one we get as a default slide. Now we want to change this a little bit to make it look a little bit more like a flashcard. We want to give a lot more room so we can have longer pieces of text in both the question and answer section. So I'm going to go to View and then Edit Master Slides. And it's going to allow us to edit any of these templates that we want, but it's going to start with the one that we're currently using, which is exactly what we want to edit. So here you can see there are two text boxes. Let's make each one a little bit bigger. So I'm going to stretch this one to go near the top and make it fill most of the slide. I'm also going to take this one, move it down, and stretch it to fill most of the bottom of the slide. So now I've got two portions like that. I also want to select each one and then go to Format and Text. And there I'll find the vertical alignment for the slide. So I'm going to set it to center so it centers the text in there. The same thing for here. I'm going to center it. Now I can play with the colors, the fonts, everything in these while I'm editing this template. One of the things I want to do is make this section here a little bit bigger, the fonts a little small. So I'm going to increase the size, make it something a little bit bigger. You'll notice that since it has five lines of sample text here, it's not actually going to grow any because it's set to shrink to fit, but that's fine. We want to leave it like that, but maybe bring it up to something like maybe 85 point. And then I'm going to click Update here to update the subtitle style. So now I've got that all set. I'm going to click Done. And now I've got my template. So let's go and put some information in these slides. So I'm going to double click in here to edit this and I'm going to paste in some text. And then I'm going to do the same thing for the answer here below. And paste it in. Now I've got a slide here with the question and answer. I like that using shrink to fit is going to really make the text fit even if it's a little bit bigger in one slide than another. The setting for text to fit is under Format, Text, and then Layout. And you can see shrink text to fit, and that's for both of these is turned on. Now before we add another slide, there's something we need to take care of. If we play this presentation here, we could see everything's presented. That's not a very good flashcard. You see the answer right away. You don't get a chance to think about it first and try to guess before the answer is revealed. So what we're going to do is make it so that the answer here doesn't show up right away. I'm going to select it and I'm going to go to Animate and then Build In here and Add an Effect. Now you could use any one of these built-in effects. Or you could just use Appear and it will just appear quickly on the screen. But to have a little more fun with it, you may want to choose something. Let's just do Dissolve and you can see it dissolve in. Now if we click Build Order here at the bottom, we could see it set to Start on Click, which is what we want. So now when I hit Play, you could see the answer doesn't appear. If I click, then I see it appears. I could also just hit the space bar or the right arrow. So this is exactly what we want. Now it'd be great to set the template to always have this appear with a dissolve like that. But unfortunately you can't put animations into a template slide. So in order to get this on every slide that we produce, instead of adding a new slide and adding a new title and subtitle template, we're just going to duplicate this. So I can select it and I can do Edit and Duplicate Selection. But Command D is a little easier. So I duplicate it. Now I have slide 2. Now I can just paste in new text into here. So I'll paste in a question and I'll paste in an answer. And that's two different slides, two different cards now. So let's create a bunch of different ones by using Command D to duplicate and then by typing in new text into each one of these or copying and pasting from another document of some sort. So now I've got my slides here. I can click on the first one. I can click play and I can go through each one using a click, spacebar, or right arrow to reveal the answer and then go to the next slide after that. so I can review all of this and get ready for my philosophy test. Now one of the things you can't easily do in Keynote is to shuffle these. But there are a couple of ways to give yourself a random one to go through. One is that you can switch the view to light table and this shows them all like this. You can even shrink them down so you can barely see what they are. And then you can drag and drop these around really easily. So you can kind of do your own shuffle. You can even select one, then hold the Command key down, select another one, and then drag those three around. And that allows you to kind of quickly sort them in a weird random order. So once you've done that a bunch, clears your mind a bit, then you can go back to the first one, play, and they'll appear in a new order. You could also print these. Now you'll think, well, wait a minute, the answer would be on the same piece of paper as the question. But you could go and print each build separately. So if I say print, and let's click show details here, you could see each slide like that. But if I select print each stage of builds, you could see the number of slides doubles to 14. And then I have the first slide, which is the question, the next one with question and answer. And now I've got basically a front and back for different slides. You might even be able to print these on each side of a sheet of paper if you have a fancy enough printer. So there's an easy way to create some flashcards on your Mac that you could use to study. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.